That's the thing that's so disturbing, I think, in the political process right now, is people who are quite smart, quite bright, they know the situation, but they also know that they can use people's fears and play on their ignorance. You know, I'm ignorant of many things. If I choose to remain ignorant, then I become stupid, you know, but I can do something about my ignorance by going out and finding out some facts and learning something. But if I choose to dismiss it all, then I really am choosing to be stupid. And it's sad to think that that's where we are in American politics, is that that gets rewarded. You know, when John Ashcroft ran for president, I remember his best line was, this is when, year 2000 maybe, or I can't remember when John was running for president. He said, we must challenge America to her great highest and best, and not accommodate her at her lowest and least. And I think that's really what people like Governor DeSantis are doing in climate, is they're accommodating America at her lowest and least, thinking that, okay, these people are tired, they don't want to lead the world anymore, they're giving out a puff, they don't have any ideas left, they're really pretty stupid, and they're pretty losers. So why don't I tell them I'll be their savior, because these other people are doing bad things to them, so I'll be their savior, and I'll be authoritarian for them. That's just a really dangerous thing to do if you're a leader. I mean, don't accommodate people at their lowest and least. Challenge them their highest and best. So about the hurricane stuff, I mean, I think just a simple Google search with credible sources coming up would inform the governor that that is not the case, that you have, I mean, just, and I don't even have to think about it in terms of great science. All you had to think of is, if you've got hot water and you know how much energy is in hot water and it's rising up and it gets in those clouds and it intensifies the storms such that they accelerate in their intensity very rapidly, isn't that commonsensical? Have you ever watched a kettle boil on a stove and seen the steam come out and the power of it? And so water at nearly 100 degrees in the Florida Keys. Oh, wow. Don't you know that's got a lot of energy in it that's feeding storms? So you don't have to be a great scientist to figure that out. You can go read a scientist and find that out, but really you can just figure it out on your own by putting a kettle on the stove. What we have to do is go to them with credible messengers and affirm some shared truth. So you actually have to go to them. You have to honor them by going to them and sitting with them. You have to send in a credible messenger, somebody who shares their views and doesn't come to them and say, I don't like you. No, you go in there and say, I like you. I like your ideas. Now let's see what we can do to solve this problem. So go to them with credible messengers and affirm some shared truth. And the shared truth, I think, is free enterprise can solve climate change. We can get innovation if you just bring accountability to the burning of fossil fuels. We're dumping for free into the trash dump of the sky. And what's happening? Well, it's like if the city dump let trash haulers dump for free, the dump would pretty soon be full, because trash haulers from every county around would hear, hey, they're letting you dump for free in that county's dump. So they bring all their trash there. The dump would fill up. That's what's happening in the trash dump of the sky. And so we just need to bring accountability. You got to pay a tipping fee for dumping into the trash dump of the sky, just like you pay at the city dump. And then good things happen. And so if you go to conservatives with credible messages and affirm that shared truth, then you're talking the language of the right of center. You're talking free enterprise language. You're talking accountability, which is a key concept for conservatives. I mean, it's also shared by progressives, but it's particularly language that makes sense to conservatives. And so that's what we think we've got to do, is go to them credible messengers and affirm some shared truth. We've got one guy in the presidential race of 2024 who wants to eke out just one more victory to redeem his condition. And he's got a very short-term horizon. He's only wants one more election. Meanwhile, you've got other Republicans, Kevin McCarthy, for example, would like to be speaker for a long time. Took him 15 ballots, so I'm sure he'd like to be speaker for a while. He has a longer-term horizon, and he sees young people coming, and he knows that young conservatives want action on climate change as much as young progressives do. And so he realizes the need for the Republican Party to present a solution. But he's afraid of that guy with a short-term view, because that guy with a short-term view is a death angel. He cannot get you elected to anything, but he can sure kill you in the primary. And so that's where we are, sadly, in my party right now, is a bunch of people afraid of the death angel. And so they go around saying silly stuff like, hurricanes don't increase in intensity when they're over hot water. That's a silly thing to say. It's just silly. And so that's why they're doing it, though, because they're afraid of that guy who has that short-term horizon.